standard form for the circle's equation is the quantity x minus h squared plus the quantity y minus k squared is equal to r squared. And we're going to use the standard form of the equation of a circle to find the center and radius of the given circle. And it's given to us in equation form. If you look at the equation that we are given in problem 1, x squared plus y squared equals 9, you notice that it's x squared. It's not x minus some quantity squared. Well, if we wrote h there, if we rewrote it, we could use a 0 in place of h and k, and 9 is r squared, which would mean that r was 3. Since it's a measure of length, we wouldn't have negative 3 as a base, we would have 3. So the center then for this particular circle from the equation, the center is 0, 0, and the radius is 3. In addition to finding those features of the circle, we want to graph in the plane. And remember, the definition of a circle is the set of points in a plane that lie equidistant from some point, some fixed point, the center. So the center is at the origin, 0, 0, and then the radius is that distance from the center, all the points lie in the plane that belong to the circle. The center is not a part of the points of the circle, it's just part of the definition. So if I graph the origin for the center and then move 3 up, down, left, right, plot points, connect those points, I then have the figure graphed for that circle. Write the standard form with h, k, and r in it above my problem, then it may dawn on me that the number for h here would be just like the first example. That would be a 0, so h would be 0. And here I have y, I have minus, so the number 1 is my k. And the radius has been squared, so the radius is 4. In graphing, I first graph the center at 0, 1. So here's the center. And then the other points on the circle that are easy to locate from that is up 4 from the center, because I have a radius of 4. And then right 4, and then down 4, and then left 4. And I can then construct the circle relatively easily in the plane with that center and that radius. One more example, when I have the center, I have the equation and I want the center and the radius, again, as I said, I would write the standard form equation either above or below the given equation. Try then to match up the symbols and determine the center and radius. This would probably be a good opportunity for you to pause and see if you can come up with center and radius before I give it to you. Standard form equation is x minus h quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared is equal to r squared. And in the standard form, x is here, but look, this is my standard form. I have minus h. This is plus 4. How would I rewrite the addition to show a subtraction? Well, I'm going to take that addition and I'm going to replace it with minus a negative. That way, I can easily identify h as a negative 4. The center is negative 4 for h. Y minus K is 3. I already have subtraction in place, so K is 3. There's the center, and R squared, R would be 3. 3 squared is 9. When I graph, I find negative 4, 3. And then from there, I move 3 right. Now, when I try to go 3 left, obviously I can't on my coordinate plane that is counting by ones. I don't think it would be too far out of bounds to just sketch in where it appears that 3 left of the center would be. If it was anything more stretched out than that, I would probably back up, erase this and count by some scale other than 1. I would probably count by a scale of 2 in order to fit this more conveniently on my axes. But regardless of which way you choose to do it, just keep in mind that I do not accept partially drawn circles. I want the circle as it would appear with, it's a connected figure. Find the equation of the circle. Express the equation in standard form. We're not given the equation this time. We're actually given the graph to start from. And we've practiced some graphing with the previous problems. And we've practiced writing the equation of a circle with problems prior to that. Finding the standard form equation requires that I know the center and the radius. In this particular problem, the center is going to be found from the figure that looks like it's about the center. And a way to tell if that's really the center is to see if I am equidistant from points on the circle. Now, I will only visually be able to determine that with 4 points, but that will be enough. Here, this is a radius length. Now, this isn't counting by ones. This actually has a distance of 4 units. And here, this would have a distance as well of 4 units. That would be 4 units, and this would be 4 units. So the R is 4. Just be very careful because this is using a scale of 2. So my R is equal to 4. And that verifies what I thought was the center is truly the center. And that would be negative 6, negative 6. Substituting those values into the standard form equation, I'm supposed to write the equation for the answer to this problem, I would have x plus 6 quantity squared, x minus h minus a negative 6 would be plus, and then y plus 6 quantity squared, squaring the r would give me 16, and that's the equation for the circle.